This is going to study the Mario Flying, and this is a course made by a GM Alex Colovic. It's a short line about the Knight of Sicilian, so e4, e5, knight f3, d6, I know e4, c5, knight f3, d6, d4 takes, yep. These are all Sicilian main lines, as you know. And yeah, once he plays knight c3, you play a6 to play the knight off. Okay, so he plays bishop e3, saying please note that the move f3 doesn't have a value because of after I play e5 after f3, no bishop here. Okay, and he retreats his knight to knight b3, and I play bishop to e6, and now and bishop to e3 now he develops, and bishop to e7, and I think yeah, this will transpose into English attack instead of the Najdorf. So yeah, not really Najdorf-ish. English attack is like meh, okay I guess. I've never faced it before online or offline, so I'm gonna dig into the line later. So yeah, e5. Wait, so bishop e7, it is important to start off this move. This move will effectively eliminates the line with early f4. White may try bishop e6, bishop e6 right here, sorry. And yeah, he can play f4. Yeah, so basically White's plan here is probably to play f4, and Black's plan is to play bishop e6, I think. So give me 1 second. So you play bishop. Oh no, what, mouse slip? That was mouse slip. Okay. He plays f3, and now you play bishop e6, developing move, logical, controlling d5. Usually when you play e5 here, your light squares are pretty weak, and you want to, yeah, you want to strengthen the light squares in d5. Logical in Sicilian. So okay, just give me 1 second. Okay, yeah, now I play bishop e6. No mouse slips this time. Okay, so let's see, he plays queen to d2, you know, preparing for queenside castle, sorry, and maybe like, and just probably go for like the push, just attack, use the pawns to attack the kingside, which is definitely logical. Am I live? It says I'm not live. I'm live? Yeah? Okay, sure. Okay, so yeah, so you play h4, just stopping g4, expanding from the king side, so logical. This is the main line, yep. Now usually when I place knight d5, you know, take advantage of the d5 square weakness after e4, which is logical, and you trade off your knight, which is logical. And also you wanna keep the bishop pair and trade off your knight instead, because yeah. No, yeah, it takes. Now he takes back, and now you play bishop to f5. Wait, so it's knight b6. Oh, so I have no idea what's the purpose of knight b6. Probably just hoping to maneuver his knight here somewhere. Even if you play here, you're gonna get trapped. Maybe hoping to play c6 if the opportunity arises. So yeah. Okay, so you play b6 just to take advantage that this knight is controlling c6, and yeah, this knight can't go to c6 and make an outpost because you just trade it off, and yeah, the pawn will be really weak. So yeah, let's continue b6, and now after it retreats, yep, to c4, yep, that's what I thought. He probably want to maneuver his knight to c4 or something. And now you play knight to d7, just preparing to maybe go to f6 or c5, knight to c5, if the opportunity arises. Yeah, a good position for a knight. Now you play knight d7. Now, yeah, okay, e4, c5, knight f3, d6, the trade off. Knight takes, you play knight f6, knight c3, and now a6. You kick the knight out, I believe. Not mouse. Stone's mouse slip again. He retreats. See, I played bishop e7. I accidentally mouse slipped, so yeah. Bishop e6. Just play h5, preventing g4. You trade off, just wanting to keep the bishop pairs, and now you play bishop f5. Knight a5 for no reason, and you play b6. Knight to c4, and now you... I forgot what you do. Knight d7, yes. Okay, got it. Nope. Sorry. E4, c5, knight f3. Yep, just practicing the lines again. Now... You kick the knight out, if I'm correct. Oh, no, a6, sorry, a6, that's like the Shveshnikov or something, I forgot. And now you kick the knight out, yeah, that's the entire purpose of the Najdorf Sicilian. We should be 7 here, castle, not castling, h5, I legit forgot everything. Ship to f5, here. C4, and now knight d7, and yeah, for better position. Let's do everything again. Here, you retreat. Bishop e7. Wait, so in this instance, instead of playing knight a5, he does a queenside castling. And you play knight bd7 instead. Just, you don't need to worry about this weak pawn. Now you play b5, expanding on the queen side. And you want to play knight b6 next. Knight b6, and hop onto d squares so you can attack this pawn. And even you might even attack these queens. Yeah, you wanna play knight b6 to control the d5 square, and maybe even threaten b4, or even play like this move as I suggested. And yeah, play this move to like play b4, and just to prevent knight a4 or something, or knight c4 from being played or something. Oh yeah, no, I mean you want to play knight f4, knight c4. Sorry, my bad. So you play here, expansion, logical. No, wait, what is, oh, you play h3, you know, I'm just trying to go for g4. You want to play queen c7, and now, so you can play knight, b6 without any worry about d file. default ending default attacks. And which is logical. No, he plays h3, queen c7. He wants to play f4 too, and you play knight b6. Control d4 and also threatens b4. Or, yeah, these two moves, and which is logical. Logical, and f4 doesn't really show anything. You just play knight here. Which, so, you bring your knight out. You expand, queen c7, knight v6, okay, you bring your knight out, bring your pawns out, queen c7, knight v6. It's just a 15-minute session, so I'm just gonna play a bit quicker here. He plays the bishop c4, Fischer's favorite attack. It's like the Fischer's chosen attack or something, if I'm not mistaken. Fischer likes to put this on c4. This is a dangerous variation targeting f7 pawn, you know? It's rarely played, according to the text. So, that's good, I guess. So, let's just look at how to respond. e6, yeah, obvious, logical. e6 prevents the bishop from aiming at f7. And e6, logical, you retreat, and you bring your knight out, yep, logical, development, wait, bishop c5, Fischer's chosen attack, this is a theory of the Fischer's chosen attack, and you play knight to c5, play knight to c5 just to maybe target this pawn in the future. After this pain has been alleviated, after this bishop like moved away, something, which is logical, and also you're attacking this bishop, maybe you might want to trade off in the future. So yeah, logical move, castle and bishop e7, logical. Okay, rook e1. This has a solid foundation and is frequently by Grandmaster Sergei Rublevsky. So you castle again, just after castling. After rook e1. So he plays f4, aggressive. Really aggressive, really sharp. f4. And now you just play h6. Just to bring the bishop back into an undefended square, and also sometimes you want to bring your knight back and just trade off your bishop, maybe, I don't know, something like that. So queen to d7, wait, give me 1 second. Give me 1 second, sorry guys. Queen d7, this move is, prepares b5, and apparently it prevents b5 or something like that. Prevents e5. Okay, let's see how it prevents e5. So, okay, it doesn't tell us. Interesting. Okay, so play 6. What do you do here? Bring your bishop. No. Do you expand? No. I don't think you expand. You bring your knight out. Oh, yeah, you bring it out. h6. Wait, no, you don't play h6. You play knight c5. And then now you develop up h6. You still play bishop e7. And now we play. Oh no, no, queen b7. Castle, yes. What am I thinking? I got all of my moves mixed up here. Okay. Legit, got everything confused. No. And now I have to place f5. Remember? No. He placed rook e1 castle. F4, h6, and then now queen d7. Okay, now I remember everything. You castle. Whoa, they're just playing repetitive moves. Bishop so then attack is like meh, not that good in my opinion. It's interesting, but it's not that good. From my experience. I was a big fan on putting my bishop at c4. But lately, I'm still a big fan, but like lately I just go for in this scenario variation, I don't develop my bishop early, I just play queen to d2 or something, and like create up all the pieces and then do a queenside castle. Sometimes kingside castle, but like I prefer this aggressive play of queenside castling. So yeah. Okay, so he plays f4. This is sharp. This is really aggressive. Okay. Should be putting a bishop on g5 and then playing f4, usually. But this is still aggressive. Knight to c5, just like usual, aiming on this pawn. And bishop to e7 is just to finish the development of kingside. And queen to f3 and just castling's just fine here. And now bishop to e3 is just really flexible move. You wanna sometimes push e5 in the future. Just keep this pawn here not in center. I even play b5 and bishop to d7. I mean queen to c7, yeah. Pretty flexible move. I legit lost track of like, not gonna lie here guys, but like I legit lost track of like the Najdorf Sicilian. Not gonna lie. Okay. So b5. Okay, so I legit forgot everything here. You play knight to c5. You don't push e5 immediately, even though I think it's a decent idea. Play bishop e7, finish a kingside development. You don't castle, you play queen to c7. No, you castle first. And then now you play queen to c7. And now, b5, expanding. Alright. I know, kingside castle. You don't need to tell me. Castle. So then attack once he retreats. You can play once he retreats, knight bd7 and f4. Okay, this is the f4 variation. So here, instead of developing a bishop, you play c5, Bishop to g5. Pretty aggressive, yep. Opposing pawn variation of h6. Time is running out to get ad-free music for I'm interested in learning MVL's poison pawn variation. This is really aggressive. Play e6. Logical, you don't want to double up your pawns. You play e6 so you can take with the queen if he takes. And now he wants to play f4, I think, next. So you play e6. He plays f4, yep, logical. h6 just to put your bishop back. Yeah, just put it on an undefended square. Queen to b6. So this is not a poison pawn variation yet, I think. Play queen to b6. Now you want him to take and... Okay, now I don't understand. Oh yeah, you have the advantage, you have h6 inserted. And the b2 sacrifice wouldn't work if you try, or if whites try to sacrifice this, I have no idea what. Bishop to f2. You can gain in tempo, I think. And if you... Okay, so... This is not really a poison pawn here. You can take, and after you play rook here, and you just move away. Even though you get a lot of activity and development, I think. It's still theory, it's still fine here. Supposedly it's decent for black. So, he takes e5. And take off the pawn on e5. After he pushes it, takes, and now you... Now it's not pinned, so you can move the knight to b5. So this is interesting. No. h6, yes. h6. Yesterday. Oh, h6, yes. I keep forgetting h6. Knight takes, you retreat. This is a really shallow line, like... You actually don't really understand how it is just pretty good for black. To be honest, I don't understand. But you... This is poison pawn variation. Supposedly with h6 inserted. It's apparently good for white because I'm not gonna go for this because it's just too risky. Like developments everywhere. Like I have to like two pieces developed and that's just not worth it, in my opinion. Developments should be number one. Okay, let's just get back to new variation. You play queen b after you play queen b6. You don't take. Oh yes, this sacrifice. Okay, so you take. You take. You retreat. Yep. Retreat here. b7 and you develop. No, this is better. This is like a decent variation. Playing e5 and then like takes and it's just too risky. Developing. Nario Sevelin. This is the rock's main line. So white wants to avoid this line where black takes on b2 because it's really sharp, and they work really well for black for poison pawn. Sounds like it works really well for black here, haha. h6 already played, and now white can't play knight to b3 since it would drop the f4 pawn. How would it drop the f4 pawn? Oh, queen to e3, check. Yes. This is. And then you drop the f4 pawn. Yes. Wait, I forgot what he put. Okay, you develop, I think. Yeah. So, okay, development logical. Castle. You shouldn't really worry about e5 in this line, as you can just play b5 and you're fine here. And now you play bishop to b7 after this push. Okay, this seems just dangerous. You know, these three pawns, you know. But it's supposedly fine for black after plays bishop b2 because you're just threatening on this pawn to take this pawn. So. I think it's supposedly good for white here, black here. And yeah, they are ready. Black is ready to counterattack, development, decent development. Compared to white's development. It's pretty equal. But black has more pieces to counterattack. Okay, bishop b7. I legit have no idea what I'm supposed to do here. I think you develop. You move your queen away. Play knight here. You expand the queen side. And yeah, you're safe. Yep, okay, I memorized all the line. Okay, I legit have like no idea what I'm supposed to do here. Okay, interesting. Okay, let's go to a new variation. This one you play f4. What? You play e5 instead. Just challenging f4 pawn, I guess. It's the best option here. Push? What do you do after the push? You retreat and now you play knight bd7. Logical? No, it prevents expansion. This move prevents expansion from the queen side, so instead you develop in the queen king side and consider like. Maybe passive b6 followed by bishop here, I think. It's fine here. I don't know. I don't really know the theory. That's why I'm bloodying. You develop bishop castles. Castles and takes. And you're just gambling the pawn, and you can win this pawn sooner or later, so it's all fine. King h1 logical, just stepping away from any checks by queen, and maybe even the bishop in the future. And knight to c5. Take on f4. Oh yeah, if they take, you can check and like you sack your b2 pawn and it isn't really good for you. Okay, understandable now. So, if your king's still here, from here. So if he takes, then you play queen b6, checking the king, and this bishop is not defending the pawn, so you're attacking the pawn. If the king moves, you take, and I think you're all king moves. You take, and you're all good here. Better here, I think. Okay, so you play knight to c5 instead. Oh, I didn't read the knight to c5 part, but okay. Whatever. Okay, so takes, yeah, recapture bishop g4. Develops and wants to get to, this bishop wants to get to g6 via g4 h5 and yeah, get to g6 and put pressure on this b4 pawn here. So yeah, interesting move, and pinning this knight too, but it isn't too much to worry about because this rook is guarding, so you can just move your queen away and not ruin your pawn structure. Okay. Push him, baby. Develop. Cross the force, I think. Yeah. Take now. And just bring your knight in. Take and play bishop g4. So yeah. Okay, I'm dreaming now. I'm high. I'm so high. You take. Okay, I am getting really tight here. Oh yeah, I've been starting for, how long has the stream been going on for? 32 minutes, okay, I thought I've been starting for at least 1 hour. Okay, let's go. Okay, give me 1 second before I move on to the next variation. Okay, let's get back now. Okay, so here you want to fianchetto instead of like playing f4 or maybe bishop here, bishop here. You just want to like go for a fianchetto variation. Pretty edgy, but not gonna lie. And e5, yep, that's always the Nario. That's what you always do when you play the Nario. If you want to push e5, put your bishop to e7, play b5, maybe bishop b2, maybe bishop e6 and sometimes. This is just logical Narayov variation. Queen to c7 also. This is really logical. Okay, castle, yep. There should be like a system called the Narayov system, because this is just really similar. So you castle and play bishop e6. You develop and now you play knight bd7. Yep, logical. Development. It prevents development, but queen b8. Queen b8. What? Okay, I am shocked. Queen b8. Maybe you want. I think he wants to. You want to push for don't. You want to expand on queen side, and if you play rook v8 instead, I think this pawn would be weak after pushing it. I don't know. Something like this. I have no idea why queen b8. So, bishop e2. Bishop e2, e5. Wait. Okay. I am confused. But association of same idea in this line, bishop e2. How is it possible bishop e2? Bishop e2. This bishop's Bianchetto. Wait. I am confused. Okay. Interesting. Queen b8. Really interesting. Okay, so do you always do the push, you know? You gotta push him, baby. Even though it's not even a pass pawn. Oh, castle, I think. Right. This is Grace, my new single, Have Fun Your Party is out. You bring a bishop out, bring a knight in. Queen b8. I'm gonna probably not gonna play that line. Because I have no idea how to play this line at all. I need to do a bit more deep digging in chess.com. Like, analysis, but this is just too simplified. Like, I actually can't understand these lines deeply. Which is kind of disappointing. Stress can come and go. So, here, I didn't realize I was playing. It can start to go away. No matter how much or how often you gamble, it can affect how you feel. Think, is that true for you? Search the effects of gambling online. Authorized by the Victoria Responsible. Same idea in the line. Okay. This is with a new Combank Platinum Awards credit card. Oh yeah. This is move 11. Okay, I'm confused. That's why I was confused. Click or tap the banner to find out more. 6 and 5 and spend $4,000 on eligible purchases by October 31, 2019, subject to credit approval, fees and charges apply. See online for more details. Yo, my favorite song, dude. Okay, let's get in there. You retreat instead of going for b3, we'll go for e2. Should be 7. Castle, and they play h3, old fashioned way. You want to play g4 and knight g3 here. So yeah, so if you play b5 expanding, maybe even considering bishop to b7. It's just a thought. B4, you want to watch to go to b5, and you can maybe play bishop here to threaten the pawn, maybe. Taking advantage. Interesting, b4 is the main line. Queen to c7, targeting this rook, but no worries. Wait, you sacrifice. I just realized, are you gonna sacrifice? I just feel this is a weird line. This is exactly. Wait, no, I'm still confused. He's still us here, and he can escape. Wait, what? I'm confused. Wait, no, what am I supposed to do? I forgot everything. Yes. Okay, I'll check the line again later. Let me check. I missed that. exchange two rooks for. After taking on a8, knight to c6. Knight to c6, and maybe. And play bishop to b7, and yeah, after queen sack and. Oh, okay, this makes sense now. A lot of sense. Okay, let's go. So, castle here in this line, instead of playing g6, h3, g4, instead of the old variation, you castle. You're concentrating on the sense instead of kingside attack if you're playing the fianchetto and the naira variation. Logical. He wants to bring in the knight jump here. Or maybe even play a4 just to stop d5. And something like this. So you're pushing immediately instead of a4, and now you don't want him to play b. You don't want black to play before, so you play knight d5, and that's your intended plan anyways, because you want to trade off. So he takes and he takes back, and then bishop to queen to c7 doesn't really work. I have no idea why. I think c7 takes here. Wait, what? Okay, you don't really want to trade. This is interesting. So, bishop to b7. You don't really want to play bishop to e6. You don't have to hurry that because you want to play knight to b7 and f6 first or something like that. You want to use the exposed queen to like gain tempo by playing knight b7, knight f6. Logical. This is interesting. Really interesting. D5 exchange, check this threatened rook. You can play, I'll check the line in the future. I'm still confused. Yo, I have 8 more levels. I don't know if I want to keep going on. But first off, I need to check off what's wrong with the line. I doubt you can see my screen here, but I'll show you. Hopefully you guys can see what is going on. Hopefully. I'm gonna try and... I'll check it later. I'll just finish the course. One more. Just one more. Oh, Mario! A6 and you respond with H3. Damn, H3! This is some Mario. This is the most commonly played line. You don't want to play E5. It's one of the rare cases. I have no idea why. Why though? Like, why? This is too simplified. We need more deep answers, not just... Okay, so you expand. You're not gonna be scared of d4, you play bishop c5 first. So, going off to f2 by taking later. Takes an. Ooh, this is like Evan's Gambit or something. Queens. Don't want to defend after. This is interesting. This is gambiting. Takes. Just take it on b2, but this one's safer. Yep. This is wow. Just wow. Equal endgame. Okay, I need to check on them all on this line because it's since it's the most commonly played line. I need to check out. Play here. I'll complete this tomorrow. I'll play a couple of games in my stream, do some tactics, if I have time, analyze some games, and then in the end, if I have time, I'll go through the scenario, because on Sunday, my opponent is going to be playing the London instead of the scenario. So tomorrow, I might be revising the London instead. So yeah, hopefully you guys are excited for tomorrow, and I'll be going.